his hand and raise your right hand, and I'm going to ask you, do you swear that the testimony you're about to give is the truth under the pains and penalties of perjury?
I do.
You can have a seat. Put yourself down to this. Can you start by stating and spelling your first and last name for the record?
Mark Reed, M-A-R-K-R-E-E-D.
How are you doing?
I'm all right. How are you?
A little nervous?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Can you tell us where you're currently living?
In Bristol.
And how long have you lived there?
Not that long.
How long, if you had to guess?
Like a couple months.
Okay. Where were you living before Bristol?
The motel.
Okay. Was that also in Bristol?
No, it was in Ashland.
How about before that?
Before that, I was staying with a friend, and before that, I was in prison.
Okay. Were you in prison here in New Hampshire?
Yeah, Concord.
Concord. Why were you in prison?
Because I got arrested in Franklin, and I went to jail, and then something happened there. I got a new charge there. It was a conspiracy to commit theft by extortion.
Okay.
And then that's when I went to prison.
Were you convicted, obviously, if you
yeah.
were in prison? Did you go to trial, or did you accept responsibility?
I took the deal.
Okay. Silly question, but was prison a good experience for you?
No, I hated it. But, I mean, I learned my lesson.
Have you made lifestyle changes since release?
Yeah, I'm sober. I'm trying to get my own apartment, my license back, car, trying to do everything. It's just, you know, it's rough.
Is it a constant struggle for you?
Oh, yeah.
And you said you're sober. When did that change happen?
When I went to prison.
So that's what it took for you to become sober?
Yeah.
When did you go to prison?
It was October 10th, 2020. I went to jail that day. I went to prison, I think it was March or April or something like that.
Of 20?
20, yeah.
Okay, thank you for clarifying.
Mm-hmm.
When I asked you, you said you currently live in Bristol. Who do you live with?
My mom and my grandmother and my brother.
So I want to turn your attention to back in 2019, specifically between June 2019 and November 2019. Where were you at in life back then?
I was a drug addict, selling drugs, doing drugs, anything really to make money. Didn't have anywhere to live. Was homeless.
It was a bad time. When you say you were doing anything to make money, was that to support you said you were a drug addict, to support your addiction?
Yeah.
How were you making money?
Selling drugs, selling guns, anything to get my hands on.
Sorry, let me back up. I want to unpack all of that. When you say you were addicted to drugs, what drugs were you using back then?
Heroin, meth, Xanax, Klonopins, anything.
And when you say you were selling drugs, what drugs were you selling?
Heroin, meth, mostly those two.
Heroin and meth?
Mm-hmm.
You also said you would sell firearms?
Yeah.
And can you explain that for me?
I knew different people that I can get them from. And I did. I got them cheap, and just I knew other people that would take them, and I would flip them because there's quick money in it.
Let me ask you this, Mark. Are you okay with me calling you Mark?
Yeah.
So back then in 2019, were you able to legally possess a firearm?
Yeah.
How about now?
No.
And is that because of your conviction?
Yeah, I'm a felon.
And you said you could buy firearms for cheap and then just offload them?
Yeah.
Was that easy money?
Mm-hmm.
So back in that time frame that we talked about, did you know someone named Adam Montgomery?
Yeah.
How did you know him?
Well, I first met him. He hit me up on Facebook saying that we went to high school together, and then we like hung out once. And I don't know, after that, I realized I never met him. I never went to high school with him. And after that, we just started talking more. Before I figured out I didn't know him, we talked more and just started like, you know, making plans to do things to make money and hanging out and shit.
So I'm gonna ask you to move a little closer. There's a microphone right in front of you to your left.
Oh, yeah.
And just, I wanna make sure that everything you say is being picked up. So if I heard correctly, and correct me if I'm wrong, he reached out to you via Facebook,
mm-hmm.
saying you went to high school together? Okay. And then you said you hung out?
Yeah.
Okay. How often would you hang out with the defendant?
Not that much. I think in total like 3 times, 4 times, something like that. It was not a lot.
Did the two of you have a drug connection?
What do you mean?
Did you do drugs together?
Yeah.
What drugs would you do?
Meth. I would do heroin by myself, but he would do meth with me.
In those limited actual face-to-face interactions you had with him, did you ever have an overnight with him, like spend the night in the same place as him?
Yeah, one time.
Sorry, I don't want you to elaborate on that.
Just, oh, okay.
A yes or no. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Did you conduct regular business transactions with the defendant?
Yes.
On one occasion, did he offer to sell you his family pet?
Yes.
And had you met that pet before?
Yes.
So I mentioned Adam Montgomery. Do you see him in the courtroom here today?
Yeah.
Can you point to him and identify an article of clothing he's wearing?
A white shirt.
And can the record reflect the witnesses identified the defendant?
The record shall so reflect.
Did you ever visit the defendant's home?
Yes.
And was that here in Manchester?
Yes.
Do you remember the address?
I think it was 70-something Guilford Street or something.
Do you remember who he was living with at the time?
There was the dog, and there was the Kayla, right? I think that's her name, Kayla, something like that, and the kid.
Okay, and when you say you think Kayla, was that an adult or a child?
An adult.
Was that the defendant's partner, or do you know?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. And so how many times did you go to his address on Guilford Street?
I think it was once or twice.
And during those two occasions, was there anyone else there?
Council approach. The objection is sustained. You may rephrase the questions.
So again, Mark, if you can move that mic actually closer to you so counsel can hear.
Yeah.
You said, did you say you went there once or twice or just once?
Once or twice.
Okay. The times that you went there, were there any other individuals at the home?
Just Kayla and the baby.
Okay. So you mentioned the defendant reaching out to you on Facebook back then?
Yeah.
Saying you went to school together. Was that the primary mechanism that he used to reach out to you?
Yeah.
Did you have a working phone at the time?
Did I?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. But it was Facebook Messenger that we're talking about?
Yes. Yes, you may.
So, Mr. Reed, I'm handing you what's been marked for identification as State's Exhibit 34, and I'm just going to ask you to take a look at that. And you can go through it. Just look up when you're done.
All right.
Okay. Do you recognize what that is?
Yeah.
And what is it?
Messages between us on Facebook.
Okay. And can you do me a favor and turn to the last page? And so the bottom message on that page, if you can look at the left, the box to the left,
yeah,
there should be a number.
1131.
Okay. Would it surprise you that you exchanged back and forth 1131 messages with the defendant?
That is a lot. That is surprising.
And what was the date of that last message?
4/7/2020.
Okay. And if you can flip back to the first page. The first message, what was the date on it?
It was 7/1/2019.
So you can set that aside. Sorry, are those the messages you exchanged with the defendant?
Yes.
You can set that aside. I want to go back. You said you were in prison at one point in 2020. Were you approached by police officers in relation to this case at some point?
Yes.
And during that interaction with them, did you consent to the search of your electronic devices, specifically your phone and your Facebook account?
Yes.
Judge, may I?
Yes.
Okay. And have you had an opportunity to compare that with the messages that you still have?
Yes.
Okay. And let me back up. All those messages that I just showed you, the over 1,100, are those still on your phone?
Yeah.
Still on your Facebook account?
Yes.
Okay. And is that the items that I just handed you? Is that a fair and accurate representation of the messages that you exchanged between back and forth with the defendant between September 25th, 2019 and October 4th, of 2019?
Yes.
Same messages?
Yes.
So at this point, Judge, I would... at this point, Your Honor, I'd move to strike the identification and offer principle.
Any objection?
No objection to 35.
The ID is stricken on exhibit 35. It's entered as a full exhibit.
You still have the exhibit, Mark?
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask that you read the first message on the first page. It should be in the top right.
I miss you too, Doug. I wish you were... Should I, like, say what it said, bleeped out, or just read the F?
So is there a redaction in part of the message?
Yeah. I know what it's supposed to say, but it doesn't say it.
That's fine. You can just say F.
All right. I miss you too, Doug. I wish you were F close the case, because I'd be there every day. I mean, dude, even Tilton's a effing hall. I mean, F an hour drive from where I'm at right now, bro. You F 45 minutes north of there, so it's like I want to come up there and kick it and S, bro, but I don't get the bread, bro. Me and my wife and my kids about to be out of the house in like 2 weeks, bro. So I'm trying to save up the F bread right now, hopefully to get us a place to go, bro. Like, if you can make me some F plays, do make me any place, bro, like, and I'll come out there, and then I would like to come out for like a stick, but you make me some place, dog, and I'll come out.
And what's the date associated with that message that you just read?
It's 9/25/2019.
Okay. And so it sounds like the defendant is and that's from the defendant to you?
Yes.
Okay. And it says incoming?
Yep.
Okay. It sounds like the defendant is describing being kicked out of there.
Sustained.
The defendant mentions bread.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Money.
So I need money?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
The ID is stricken. They're entered as full exhibits.
Yes, you may.
So, Mark, I'm handing you what's been marked for admitted as state's exhibits 8 through 17. And I'm just going to ask you to take a look at those. And look up when you're done. Do you recognize those exhibits?
Yes.
What are they?
They're messages from my phone on Facebook between me and Adam.
Okay. And are those fair and accurate photographs of the messages that were on your phone?
Yes.
Do you recognize the phone that's in those?
Yeah.
It's mine. Yours?
Yeah.
And Your Honor, at this point, I'd ask to publish.
Yes, you may. Okay, and starting with the first image that I handed you, Mark, if you could just describe what's depicted.
He's telling me where he lives and that he can come to me, but I
don't know. And so that address that's mentioned there, the 77 Guilford Street, is that where you met the defendant?
Yes.
To the next. There was a phone number that was provided. Is that a phone number that you would use to communicate with the defendant?
Yeah.
skipping to and so this is the October 3rd, 2019 at 10:26.
And if you could just read that communication, starting with the first bubble, it looks like a call.
Says you missed a call from messenger user.
Okay, and the next one?
Your mark, hit me up, dog. I got something you really going to like. You got to hit me up now, ASAP.
Oh, sorry, just a sec. So the person that's writing, I got something you're really gonna like. Is that an incoming? So is that you that wrote that or is that someone else?
No, that's somebody else who wrote to me.
Okay. And this is your communication with the defendant?
Yeah.
All right. And if you can go on to the next message.
You got to hit me up ASAP. You're going to miss out on it, bro. If you don't hit me up now, you should girls phone something and call. You missed a call from messenger user. 603-858-333.
Okay, so the individual is providing you some phone numbers. Okay, you can go on to the next exhibit. And if you could just read the exhibit number that you're on.
12?
Okay, and so you can read 12.
L, then you're gonna miss out, cuz I'm not messaging this shit. What the fuck, bro, come on. There's a house phone there. You guys have cell phones up there. You guys have some type of service. Bro, Facebook is too choppy and it's too notch. I don't need shit like, S, like this on messages and then Facebook. Dog, you got. Okay, buddy, I called you first because, yeah, I called you first because I know you were going, I don't know what it says underneath that one, going something like this. I can't read what it says underneath that.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's go to the next message.
All right. There's no way you can call. Just let me know that because I don't want to sit here and keep playing this game. I got 100 other people that be looking for a dog.
All right, let's go to 13.
How much I want. That's from me.
So you wrote how much I want?
Yeah.
And what was the response to that?
He said, which one do you want? Both of them or which one? And I said, price of each.
So at the top of those, that exhibit, 13, it looks like there's some other messages. For how much I want. Yeah. And then
mixed it up.
It's okay. You've reviewed those, they're fair and accurate.
Yeah.
I'm gonna ask you to turn back to the exhibit 35 that I handed you. And I'm looking at page 2. And the top of page 2, if you can start with the incoming message, L, then you're gonna miss out.
Yeah, L, then you're gonna miss out because I'm not messaging this S. And then I put, what the F, bro, come on. there's a house phone there. You guys have cell phones up there. You guys have some type of service. Bro, Facebook is too choppy and it's too top, too notch. I don't need S like this on messages and then Facebook, dog, you got. Okay, buddy, I called you first. Yeah, I called you first because I know you were going to want this, but there's no way you can call. Just let me know that because I don't want to sit here and keep playing this game. I got 100 other people that be looking for a dog.
Okay, and then is there a call after that? An incoming call?
Yeah.
Okay, and if you can go to the next message.
Alright. It will, don't ask me for this S later on, bro, because you're slacking right now. I have something right now that you've been looking for a grip, bro. Hit me up ASAP. And then I write, yo, if it's metal, I want it.
And let me stop you right there. What does that mean? You wrote that. If it's metal, I want it. What does that mean?
Guns.
Guns? Okay. If you can go to the next message.
Sir, I'm just going to ask you to please keep your voice up. It's a big room and everybody needs to hear you.
All right, sorry. It is, bro. It's the big boys. How much?
If you can flip to the next page and continue.
I can't hold it. First come, first serve. Damn, bro.
You write in damn, bro.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then there's 3 unsent messages.
Okay, and let's talk about that. Those are incoming messages?
Yes.
That were unsent?
Yeah.
What were they?
Pretty sure they were the pictures.
Pictures of what?
The pump and the AR.
Okay, the pump and the AR. And when you say the pump, what does that mean?
Shotgun.
Okay, so pump action shotgun?
The 12 gauge, yeah.
12 gauge. Can you describe the pictures to the best of your recollection?
All I remember is that the 12 gauge had something special on it. That's why he wanted more for it and not what I offered him. I don't know. I know it was black. I can't really remember much.
Were the photos, were the firearms that you just referenced, were they resting on something or being held?
I think they're resting on something.
Let's go to the next message after the unsent photographs.
How much?
You can continue. So you wrote how much?
Yeah. And then I want. And then he put, which one do you want? Both of them or which one? And then I put price of each. And then again, unsent message.
Do you recall what that unsent message was of?
I don't.
Okay. Let's go to the next message.
But we can work something out. What's some other S? This is why I need you to call me.
And that was from the defendant?
Yeah. But I literally have people blowing me up right now as we speak. But you, my dude, so I called you first. And then there's just a bunch of zeros.
So there's a phone call, it appears?
Yeah.
And that's an incoming phone call?
Yeah.
If you can flip to the next page and continue reading.
I want the 12 gauge, but I don't got 3V.
And let me stop you there. 3V, what does that mean?
I think it was 3 sticks at the time.
And what do you, when you say 3 sticks, what does that mean?
A stick is 10 grams of dope.
Of dope?
Yeah.
And sorry, again, just heroin. Another detail. What is dope?
Heroin.
Heroin.
Yeah.
So 3 sticks of heroin?
Mm-hmm.
And how much is a stick?
It all depends where you go and who you get it from. But usually like $200.
Sorry, not the price, but the quantity. Do you know?
Oh. 10 grams.
10 grams.
Yeah. So that'd been 30 grams for 30 three grams. Sticks.
And you can continue reading.
All right. Because 8 got to pick up and down. I'll take it. How much? I'll take a stick for the pump, but I also need like $80 cash. So let me know.
And so those were from the defendant. I'll take it. I'll take a stick for the pump.
Sustained.
The messages that you just read, are those incoming or outgoing?
Incoming.
And so you left off, so let me know. You can continue.
Yeah. Because if not, so what's the deal, bro? Because I can't wait around all day. Is this a yes and no, maybe so? What's going on? And then I put, I'm trying to figure it out.
Okay, and does it continue?
Yep. Hi, man. I mean, if you get to me first, then awesome. But you're trying to figure it out, so that's basically saying no or that you don't have it. So I told you, buddy, I can't wait around with it, bro. So, I mean, if you hit me up before anybody else does, then it's yours. But if somebody else comes here with the bread, then I got to take. Because we need the bread ASAP, bro. We're about to be kicked out of my any day now house.
And I think you mentioned earlier, but bread refers to money.
Yeah.
You can go to the next page.
Yo. And then after that, there's a bunch of, it's incoming call. And then again, yo.
And that's an incoming?
Yo? Yeah.
Is that incoming?
Yep.
And the next message?
What?
The next message?
It says, you missed out.
And is that incoming or outgoing?
It's incoming.
Okay.
And now it's outgoing. I said, can you send a pic? And then again for me, yo.
Okay, the you missed out is incoming though?
Yeah.
Okay. So you can set those aside. When you would communicate with the defendant via this Facebook account, how would you know that you were communicating with the defendant?
Well, because when I'm talking to him, it's like when I'm talking to anybody else. If you know who you're talking to, or if you talk to that person before, it doesn't matter how they say it. Like, you don't have to hear their voice and know it's them, just the words they say and how they use their words. Plus, later on in some of the messages, I was talking to Kayla, and she wrote her name in the way she writes. You can tell the two apart.
Okay, did he have a particular way of speaking or referring to you?
Yo, dog.
Does anyone else call you that?
No.
When you would arrange to meet with the defendant, who would arrive?
Huh?
When you would arrange meetups with the defendant, who would arrive?
Him.
Okay. Not Kayla?
No.
I think you testified that you still have the communication on your phone?
Yes.
And in your Facebook account?
Yes.
Do you still have the same Facebook account?
Yes.
And how about the, how about the profile that you communicated with?
That I was talking to?
Is it still in existence?
I think it's deactivated, but it's still on my mind. Like, I can see everything there. Just, there's no name now.
There's no name now?
Yes.
Back when you communicated with that account, was there a name?
Yes.
What was the name?
Adam Montgomery.
Did you want to purchase the firearms?
I mean, I did, yeah, but I didn't end up doing it.
Did you want to purchase both or just one?
Just one.
Was that the shotgun?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know. I just, they're easier to get rid of.
I can have just a moment. One of the messages that you read aloud mentioned Facebook being two-notch. Do you know what that means?
I assume that's like...
Hold on 1 minute. Basis? Go ahead. You may answer the question.
All right. I'd assume that it's like... it's.
Approach. Sustained, you may rephrase the question.
Mark, do you know what that means? Two notch? Facebook's two notch?
It's too smart. Like it's.
Overruled.
Go ahead.
It's always there. You know, it's. I don't know. I don't know how to say it.
So it's always there.
Yeah, the I guess it never goes there. Away, you know?
It never goes away.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we discussed, I think, some of the messages you read, maybe the one that's up on the screen. It discusses, you read, message was unsent.
Yeah.
What does that mean, based on your experience with Facebook?
That the person that sent it, unsent it, they, I don't know, I guess deleted it or whatever. But okay. It would Have say you, unsent.
Is that something you're familiar with on Facebook?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Reed.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Carrie Smith. And I have some questions,
but I just feel too far away from you. So, can I call you Mark?
Yes.
Now, do you have the exhibits that are the regular pages, not the photographs? You have them there with you?
35.
Exhibit 35, thank you.
Yep.
Okay. So, let's just get a couple of things clear for the jury as they look through this later. There's a time column in those pages, right?
Yes.
And let's look at the first message. It's one, two, three, third message that says, "You're Mark, hit me up, dog. I want something. You really gonna like this." Do you see that message?
Yes.
And going over to the time column, it says 2/29/02.
2/29/20.
Thank you. 2/29/20, right?
Yep.
But your phone actually has a different time, right?
What do you mean?
there's different times reflected on your phone messages than are on this piece of paper, right?
I'm confused.
I understand. So you have the photographs here?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's get a photograph that shows the message time on your phone, okay? Let's see. Here's one. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong about this. Maybe they are at the same time. Can you send a pic? Is sent at 3:44? Is that right?
Hold on, let me check.
I think I'm going to take that back. They are the same time,
yeah,
aren't
they? Yeah, they're the same.
And you said, by the way, can you send a pic? That refers to the dog, right?
I don't know. Can I go back and reread?
Sure.
I don't know.
Okay, that's fine. So we'll go through some of those messages, and it seemed like from what I saw on direct, it's easier for you to read from the pages than it is from the photographs. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. So let's talk about the message at 2:45:12. It's an incoming message, and it says, I have something right now that you've been looking for a grip, bro. Hit me ASAP. Is that right?
Yep.
And from the word grip, you understood that it referred to a gun?
No, a grip means a long time. The metal was what I identified as the gun.
Okay. So, you asked, yo, if it's metal, I want it.
Yes.
Meaning that you would take, you were in the market for a gun.
Guns.
Not necessarily for yourself, but to flip it.
Yes.
And one of his responses was, I keep talking about his. Your Honor, at this time, can we introduce the stipulation with regard to the address?
Any objection from the state?
No objection.
All right. Attorney Smith's stipulation A, this to be read now. Is that accurate?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to read to you a stipulation. This is a stipulation or an agreement by the parties. The parties stipulate as fact that the October 3rd, 2019 Facebook communication that Mark Reed had regarding the sale slash purchase of firearms was through a Facebook account, account number 10000907885803. That Mark Reed had communicated with Adam Montgomery through regularly. I'm going to read that again, okay? The parties stipulate as fact that the October 3rd, 2019 Facebook communication that Mark Reed had regarding the sale slash purchase of firearms was through a Facebook account, that Mark Reed had communicated with Adam Montgomery through regularly. Okay? I didn't read the account number again because I know you all have that memorized. Go ahead.
So we will be clear. As far as you're concerned, you are communicating with Adam Montgomery, right?
Yes.
Because you've communicated with him before on this address, right?
Yes.
And there's no doubt in your mind because of the address, the dog that you recognized, and his manner of speaking, right?
Yes.
And one of the things in his manner of speaking is a little bit in code, right?
Yes.
It's like, I got 100 other people that be looking for a dog, right?
Yeah.
That was kind of code. Yeah. And when he was talking about Facebook being, what was that word that was used?
Top notch.
Okay. That was code, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And so you said, if it's metal, I want it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And his response to you is, it is, bro, it's the big boys. You asked how much, and kind of at the same time, it's like interchanging inner, whatever, messages. I can't hold it first come, first serve, right?
Yeah.
So he's telling you that he can't hold it for you, right?
Yeah.
And he sends pictures, right?
Yeah.
And these pictures are with the guns on something, right?
Yeah.
He said that they were actually on something, they weren't being held, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you were interested in the 12 gauge, you said, right? But when you, I'm sorry, you have to say.
Yes, sorry.
It's okay. When you were having this conversation with Adam, he asked you, which one do you want? Both of them or which one, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you asked, well, what's the price of them, right?
Yeah.
So you weren't turning down either, right?
No.
You want more information.
Yeah.
Might be one, might be the other. Okay. And there was some sort of message that was sent and called back, right?
Yeah.
And then there's a message that says, we can work something out. That's why I need you to call me, right?
Yes.
He says, I literally have people blowing me up right now as we speak, but you, my dude, I called you first.
Yeah.
And this, by the way, is around 2:51:49, exactly 2:51:49, right?
Yes.
And so you say that you want the 12 gauge, but you don't have the purchase ability.
Yes.
And the other thing is that you have to go pick it up if you get it, right? Is that what pick up and down was?
Oh, I had to go pick up and down as in meth and heroin, yes.
Ah, so you're saying that you have drugs both that for up and down?
Yes.
As purchase abilities?
Yes.
Okay, so you're making the offer out there for what you have to be able to get the guns, right?
Yes.
And Adam says, I'll take it. Right?
Yes.
And you say, how much? Right?
Yes.
And he says, I'll take a stick for the pump, but I need $80 in cash.
Yes.
So I think that you were saying a stick is
10 grams.
10 grams.
Yeah.
But you didn't have three sticks, and he agrees to take a stick and $80.
Yes.
And a stick is normally worth $200?
Usually.
Okay. And that didn't work out, right?
No. I didn't have the $80 cash.
Okay. And he couldn't hold it for you, right?
Right.
And so he told you later, can't hang around all day, right?
Yes.
And eventually it was that you missed out.
Yes.
In the meantime, he let you know he needs the bread ASAP because he's about to be kicked out any day, right?
Yes.
And that was sort of something you knew, or he had actually told you that that was why he wanted to sell his dog to you, right?
Yes.
That wasn't for you to resell on, that was for you, right?
Say that again, please.
The dog.
Yes.
Was for you.
Yes.
If you wanted to buy it.
Yes.
Because he couldn't hold on to the dog because he was being evicted.
Mm-hmm.
And he sent you a picture of the dog with his child.
Yes.
Right? And that wasn't related to the business of buying and selling. That was hoping that you would take the dog because he was being evicted, right?
Yes.
And your felony was conspiracy to commit...
Theft by extortion.
Theft by extortion. And that was a crime that you committed while incarcerated.
Yes.
And you got some time that could be suspended on that, right? You got time plus you could earn a suspension of some of the time, right?
Yes.
Okay. And the police, you went, that conviction was on 3/17/21. Sound right?
Yes.
And it was about a year later that police came talking to you about Adam.
Yes.
And you agreed to talk to him?
Yes.
Told him about the messages. I'm hiding nothing, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mark, I have a silly question for you, but what does first come, first serve mean?
And the first person gets there is theirs.
Okay. Attorney Smith asked you about your conviction.
Yes.
And about your sentence. When police approached you at the jail, first of all, do you remember who you spoke with at the prison?
No, not. I know there was a marshal, and I think the other one was a Manchester detective.
Does Detective Dunleavy sound?
I think so.
And when you say marshal, U.S. Marshal Service?
Yeah, I don't know his name. I forgot.
Okay. And so these gentlemen approached you, and they wanted to talk?
Yes.
Did they promise you anything?
No.
Throughout all of this, have you been promised anything?
No.
Did you ask for any favors?
No.
Did you ask for any deals?
No.
Did you say, let me out of prison?
No. I wish it worked like that, but no.
So you've got nothing for your testimony?
No.
You just told the police what you knew?
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Reed. No further questions, Judge.
Right.
So, I have to get, find the thing. The police, when they came to you when you were in prison, your deal was complete, right?
Yes.
And you were serving your time, right?
Yes.
And you were earning that extra time to try and get out early, right?
By doing a
focus.
Resident treatment unit there, yep.
At Focus?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, not Focus, sorry. It was I was supposed to go to the Focus, but I ended up being able to do an outside program, a sober living, and then a rehab, then sober living. But,
So you were in the halfway house at the time?
No.
Oh, okay. So anyway, you were earning your time out, right?
Yes.
And when did you get released?
It was May 26th of last year, the day before my birthday.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So when the state asked if the police promised you anything, it was your intention, although you said it would have been nice if you could just do it that way, to put your head down, work through this, and make the changes that you wanted to, right?
Yes.
And you you were not a felon when you were having this conversation with Adam Montgomery, right?
No.
It was after the fact that you got in jail and then in prison.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Any objection?
No.
All right, you may step down.
Thank you.
And this witness is excused. Counsel approach.